A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 2nd October, on the front page you have Supreme Court defers hearing on pleas challenging Jammu and Kashmir bifurcation. So this is regarding the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act. It is effective from 31st October, and central government and Jammu and Kashmir government have been given time till 14 November to file their counters. So this is the status presently of the case in Jammu and Kashmir. The Constitution Bench of Supreme Court did not intervene in the implementation of Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act from October 31. It has given time till 14 November for the government. Then this is no curbs thrust on Kashmiris center. So it says 100% landlines are working. So mobile phones are not working, but landlines are working. And it is said that mobile phone service lines started in Jammu and Kashmir only in 2005. If mobile started, WhatsApp messages will come. If mobile start, messages will come from across the border. So that's why they are not allowing mobiles to start, but they are saying like landlines are working. And this is verdict diluting SCST anti-atrocities law recalled. So Supreme Court had in March 2018 given its verdict in which it had diluted the provisions of SCST Act, anti-atrocities Act. So this means the people who are accused of a case under this Act, they were allowed to get anticipatory bail. You know, provisions were diluted. The Supreme Court bench at that time had said that the act has been misused. It was a two-judge bench, you should recollect. So a review petition had been filed. There were protests, because of which even central government changed its stance. Central government amended the SCST Act in such a way that the Supreme Court order is nullified. But now in a review petition, Supreme Court has recalled that verdict which had diluted SCST Act. Then this is GST collections fall a record low in September. So this is regarding GST monthly collection. So it is at a 19 month low at 91,916 crores. On page 9 you have Odisha bans single use plastic from today. So Odisha government has banned single use plastic in all urban areas of state from Gandhi Jayanti as such. So the state Forest and Environment Department, in a notification issued on September 30, said government has prohibited manufacture, sale, trade, import, storage, transportation and distribution of single-use plastic. On the editorial page, the first editorial is, the worst may be over. So this is regarding how the economy is now showing positive signs, though a turnaround is some distance away. So, 8 core sectors growth also, they were in the negative territory for the first time in over 4 years in August, the news had come. But it is said, however, other high frequency data on the economy suggests that worst might be over, like vehicle registrations have witnessed a strong comeback in September. So, that is it. The second editorial is difficult compromise. So, it is in Austria, we had seen the news how the political parties, how they have fared in the Austrian elections, and it seems the Conservative Party will have to seek common ground with political rivals because it could not get majority on its own. Mr. Kurz's party, Sebastian Kurz's party. Then the lead article is, since today is Gandhi Jayanti, recovering Gandhi's religious vision. So this is an article which says that it's time to challenge the idea of religion as a monolith and follow Gandhi, who encouraged multiple religious attachments. And this is, what would Gandhi say about the Indian media? So this article says that he would be delighted to see the rise of regional and social media and would be appalled by the spread of fake news. Then on the op-ed page you have, Gandhi has not spoken his last word. So this article says that for those who believe in the value of non-violence, the Gandhian legacy is still in force. And this is again regarding Gandhi, a struggle against social orthodoxy. So how Gandhi's visit to Vaikom paved the way for the trump of the Satyagraha. So Vaikom Satyagraha, which took place, that is detailed out here. In 1925, Gandhi arrived at Vaikom, and here you can see, within an hour of Gandhi stepping on Vaikom soil, events gathered pace. And Gandhi had received a registered mail on the dais from Orthodox Brahmins taking exception to his views on untouchability. that was the issue here, and Vaikom Satyagraha, which took place here, is of significance. You should know about it. So preceding Gandhi's visit, Vaikom Satyagraha had seen many ups and downs. So Travancore state administration initially was aggressive, later it mellowed down, and you know, so it was untouchability and temple entry not allowed, which was seen. It was actually Vaikom temple, as where you know, where lower castes were not allowed. So, and below you have again Gandhi and Gita, on how Mahatma Gandhi put into practice teachings of the Gita in his own moral and political actions. Then on page 13 you have, this is also little news on front page, opposition demands Fadnavis's resignation, CMO denies claims. So Maharashtra CM faces charges of suppressing information in two cases. So this is Chief Minister of Maharashtra Devendra Fadnavis. For him, the Supreme Court has set aside the Bombay High Court order that gave him a clean chit in a case of not disclosing criminal matters in a 2014 poll affidavit. So here you can see, it is said Fadnavis has no right to contest elections which are scheduled to be held on October 21, is what the opposition says. And this is Aditya Thackeray. He is going to become the first Thackeray in three generations to fight a direct election. Thackerays have never fought direct elections. Then this is Bangladeshis living illegally in UP to be identified and deported. So this is a move, it is said, important for internal security in the state. So now an exercise similar to what we have seen in Assam, in RC exercise, seems to be initiated here in UP. On page 14 you have the Modi factor in US politics. So it says if PM's diaspora politics tries to tilt the scale in favor of Trump, it will have repercussions. So, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, it seemed, endorsed US President Donald Trump for his 2020 re-election bid in his Houston speech on September 22, 2019. So, did he wade into domestic politics of US is the question raised. And these questions have resurfaced when External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar rebuffed suggestions that he did both during an interaction with Indian journalists in Washington, D.C. The answer to the first question is no, the minister is right on that, that you know, he did not endorse the US president, and yes, and the second is yes, and the minister is wrong on that, it says. So he waded into domestic politics of US is yes, and what are the repercussions for it for India are discussed here. Then below you have US Commerce Secretary may raise key trade issues. So this is Wilbur Ross, who is US Commerce Secretary, is going to arrive in India today and will hold talks with Nirmala Sitharaman and Piyush Goyal. So what are the key trade issues in India, you will come to know. And of course we have discussed this because the mini trade deal also did not come forth, like the issue on price caps on medical equipments, on software, you know, so rollback of tariffs, import duties on information and communication technology. So all these are the demands of US, and India also has its own demands, like we want GSP to be status to be reimposed now, re-awarded as such. So that is also there, which India demands, and more market access for agricultural goods in USA, etc. So again, talks are going to take place on these key trade issues. On international page, you have this news, no force can shake the Chinese nation, Z. So this is regarding how China marks 70th anniversary of communist rule with a huge military parade in Beijing. So this is also an analysis of three challenges before Z. So economy is slowing down while political and geopolitical tensions are rising. And this again with respect to China. Police shoot Hong Kong protester at close range. So the officer discharged his firearm after coming under attack now. So his unit was attacked by demonstrators during sustained clashes in the city, and he discharged his firearm later. The wounded protester received initial first aid from officers before paramedics arrived. Then this is US panel to hold hearing on South Asia on October 22. So this is a US panel, US House of Representatives panel, you can see a subcommittee of US House of Representatives which is going to hold hearings on South Asia, and the focus will be on human rights situation in Kashmir. And this is North Korea, US to resume talks on October 5. So the two nations have now agreed to resume nuclear negotiations on October 5 following month-long stalemate over the withdrawal of sanctions in exchange for disarmament. So USA wants North Korea to disarm and North Korea wants sanctions to be withdrawn, but how the pace would go on both is not clear. US insists that first it should completely disarm, then only all sanctions would be revoked, and North Korea says it should be a gradual process. So there was a no agreement as such which came forth, because of it the talks also stalled, but now they will be resumed. And this is Johnson to table new Brexit plan. So this will come in news, like he says a new Brexit deal will be revealed very soon. The deadline is of 31st October, by which if a deal is agreed, then Brexit would take place on that day, otherwise Brexit would be delayed. Then on business page you have auto sales slump, continue to slump in September. So though the editorial said that auto sales are now picking up, but here you can see the news that sales slumps continue in September as such too. But it said industry is hopeful of buyers returning to the market in the festive celebrations. And this is again, manufacturing activity remains flat in September. So industry has been hit by subdued demand and manufacturing activity has been flat. This is Nikkei India Manufacturing Purchasing Managers Index, which came at 51.4 in September. It's the same reading as in August, so it has remained the same. Then on the last page you have unusual movement of moths and butterflies causing a flutter. So scientists are worried that climate change is prompting a habitat change in Himalayas. So butterflies named Himalayan tailless bush blue, is known to occur at an altitude between 1300 to 2400 meters in Jammu and Kashmir and Uttarakhand, but recent studies have located the species at higher places in Uskut Wildlife Sanctuary in Uttarakhand, which is 1200 meter higher than its known range. So this is a cause of concern as such, because climate change is prompting changes in habitat too. Here again, a climate change related worry. Huge iceberg breaks off Antarctica. So more than 1500 square kilometer iceberg recently broke off Antarctica. But it is said the event is part of normal cycle and is not related to climate change. And this is humans pollute more than volcanoes. So this is a study which says that carbon dioxide emissions by humans are 100 times greater than those by volcanoes. And this is regarding 100th birth anniversary of Kalashnikov, who was the designer of AK-47. He is regarded as national hero in Russia. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.